Hey, welcome back, friends. TechDale here, and today I want to talk about the Song of Saren weekend. Now, Song of Saren weekend is like a minor double experience weekend. It only does give you a 1.5 times experience boost to a subset of skills, and then after 2 hours of that subset of skills being boosted, it will switch over to another subset of skills. The three subsets are Support, Combat, Gathering, and Artisan. Very similar to the way that Dungeoneering works. You can look up the Dungeoneering potions and see which skills are underneath which of these categories. As I previously mentioned, they are not all going to be active at all times, so it's not as good as a double experience weekend. But if you are patient and you don't have a whole lot of training to be doing on any of these specific skills, you should be at least able to hit one of these time periods in order to have 2 hours of the 1.5 times experience. On top of that, there are additional benefits to each of these. I'm going to go over them separately, but it makes them even more beneficial to train during certain time periods. The first song that Saren can sing is going to be for support skills. Now, we do know that Dungeoneering, Thieving, and Slayer are going to be three of the skills that are going to be boosted by the 1.5 times experience. I would care to wager that they were probably going to add Agility and Hunter into this as well, though it is not guaranteed. There are also three additional benefits for the support skills during this time period. The first one is going to be no XP penalties from dying in Dungeoneering. This just allows you to get faster Dungeoneering floors without having the downside of dying and losing some of your experience. The second one is going to be increased loot and chance of getting totems while safecracking. Seeing as how safecracking is actually the meta for thieving right now, this is just a boost on top of the 1.5 times experience boost for thieving, so very nice to do safecracking during this time period. And last but not least, all Slayer tasks act as if you have VIP tickets. Now, this is a little bit strange because they are allowing you to do Slayer during the support section, but combat is actually a separate section, so I'm not sure if it's actually going to be the best time to do Slayer during this weekend. I would personally probably just wait for a double experience weekend, but if you are low on VIP tickets, this is going to be a slight benefit on top of the 1.5 times Slayer experience. The second song is going to be Combat. Now, Combat is going to be the traditional combat skills: defense, ranged, magic, melee, and constitution, and it does have a couple extra benefits on top of it. You do get plus one to all charm drops. That means that something like Nex that already drops a ton of charms, not going to be the best thing to be training or doing during this combat section. Instead, you're going to want to be doing something that only drops one charm quite frequently, something like Water Fiends or Rock Lobsters. This is going to be a big boost to the amount of charms that they're going to be dropping, and since they're already pretty good to start out with, it's essentially just going to be double charms. You are going to have a decreased cost of instances. This is very good for the lower to mid-end bosses that do cost an amount of GP in order to create an instance and actually go bossing at. That being said, it does kind of not really mesh with the charm drops because most bosses are not really the best charm droppers, and even if they are, they drop multiples at a time. So I'm not sure that the decreased cost of instances is going to matter at all, but if you're planning on doing bossing, you might as well get a slight decrease in the cost. And last but not least is going to be one auto resurrection to full health per run in elite dungeons. I think this is going to be the best buff for this. It's going to allow people that haven't done elite dungeons such as myself to really give elite dungeons a try. Worst comes to worst, you just get resurrected one time and you go, okay, I'm good. I don't need to actually keep going with this dungeon as a worst case. In my opinion though, I think that if you are good at elite dungeons, this is not really that big of a deal to you. It's just a little bit of a safety blanket. Doubt that many people that are really grinding out elite dungeons really need this auto resurrection. The next song is going to be the Gathering song. Now, Gathering is a little bit flexible with this definition, so I'm not 100% sure which skills are going to be considered underneath Gathering. They do mention Divination and Farming in the Gathering section, but traditionally the Gathering skills would also include Woodcutting, Mining, and Fishing. I'm not 100% sure which skill is going to be 1.5 times boost, but none of these skills are especially good to be training during this weekend anyway, because they are gathering skills, so they do give you GP as well as XP for most of the training methods. That being said, if you are planning on training them anyway, this is a good time to train them, and there's a couple extra benefits. The first one is going to be 10% chance not to deplete Uncharted Isle resources. This is a minor buff to Uncharted Isles. Essentially, you could just go get another island, so it's not that big of a buff. It just increases the AFK of it. But it is a minor buff to Uncharted Isles. Next up is going to be training hotspots in Hall of Memories. Don't move as often. This just, again, makes it more AFK, not quite as click intensive. Not many people are going to be training in Hall of Memories anyhow, since the Guthixian cache is the best way to train for divination, but it is an option if you want to grind out your divination. And last but not least is the weirdest buff in the world, 10% more beans for selling items at player owned farms. I'm not entirely sure why they added this. It's a minor buff and it just allows people to stockpile their animals. It's not like you can really stockpile the entire month, though, because you can only sell a certain number of them each day before the seller or the buyer actually leaves. So I'm not 100% sure what they're thinking with this, the 10% increase on beans. But if you want to, you can go ahead and store up all of your animals and sell as many of them as you can during this weekend as an option for you. And last but not least is going to be the Artisan Song of Saren. Now, this is personally my favorite section because of the skills that are involved in Artisan. The Artisan skills are going to be cooking, construction, crafting, fire making, fletching, herb lore, rune crafting, and smithing. Now, these are all very good skills to train during the double experience weekend, so I imagine that many people are going to be training them up during the 1.5 times experience as well if you don't want to wait until the next double experience weekend. On top of all these skills giving you 1.5 times experience, it is going to be a reduced chance of burning food when you are cooking. This is a minor buff to people that are training up the cooking skill, but if you have 99 cooking and are wearing the cooking cape anyhow, not really a buff to cooking. 2.5% chance to save a secondary when making potions. Small buff to herb lore, seeing as herb lore is already one of the best skills to train during a boosted experience weekend period. This is probably just going to make herb lore even a little bit better. And last but not least is going to be increased node spawns and double rewards in RuneSpan. I personally really like this one because it allows you to get the double rewards, which means more unstable essence or massive pouches or whatever you really are choosing to use with your reward points. The majority of the things for reward points are very good to use during double experience weekend though, such as unstable essence. It's very fast experience. So this is going to be increased XP and increased rewards so that you can get better experience during the next double experience weekend as well. All in all, I think Artisan is going to be the one that the people hit up the most, but let me know what you're planning on doing down in the comment section. I personally am probably planning on doing RuneSpan and a little bit of Slayer during the support section, but it may be time to do a little bit of Elite Dungeons as well during the combat section. Also, hit that like button if this helped you out, and subscribe to the channel if you want to see the rest of my content. As always, though, have a good one.